Hey guys, in this video I'm going to show you how to install Windows 10, either a copy you bought online or something you've downloaded onto your brand new SSD or maybe an old drive that you have laying around that you want to repurpose. So this video will get you started step by step on how to do it all. So let's get started. All right, so we're going to want to take out the thumb drive and just plug it into an available USB port. Of course, the first time you plug it in, it's always wrong. Then you're going to want to turn the computer on. Okay, so when you start up your PC for the first time, right when you see the logo on your screen, maybe for your motherboard or your PC manufacturer, you're going to start wanting to hit the delete or the F2 key to enter into the BIOS. Now, every single motherboard, every single PC is going to have a different BIOS. So it's going to look a little bit different on yours, but the overall is relatively the same. Okay, so right when you get into your BIOS, you're going to want to go over to the boot setting or the boot section. Then you're going to want to scroll down, and one very important thing, you're going to have a few different settings here for your fixed boot order priorities. Make sure Windows 7 installation is set to disabled. Make sure your boot selection is set to UEFI because Windows 10 is a UEFI operating system. So then we're going to scroll down a little bit till you find UEFI USB key drive BBS priority or something along the lines of USB. You're going to click on there. Over here, you're going to find the thumb drive that you have Windows 10 in. Might look a little bit different, but just make sure that that particular drive shows up here. Okay. And then you're going to want to select for your boot option number one. You're going to want to come down here till you see that particular thumb drive or that USB key that you've plugged into your computer. You're going to want to select that. Okay. Now we're going to press F10 to save and exit or whatever your key combination is, or just come over here to the save and exit setting, then click save changes and reset your computer, and then yes. Now what that's going to do is it's going to go ahead and boot us into the thumb drive, becoming our first drive to boot from. So then here we're going to be able to select, depending on how you made your drive, or if you have an authentic Windows 10 thumb drive, it's going to give you this option. More than likely, you're going to want to install on Windows 10 64-bit. That depends on your CPU, and I'll go over that in a different video, but I'm going to select 64-bit. Now, the entire process is going to take about under 7 minutes usually. You know, it might take a little bit less time if you have an even faster computer, or even more if you have a slower computer or a mechanical hard drive. But I'm just giving you an example on how all of this works. Okay, then here we're going to select your language, your time and currency format, and your keyboard input method. Okay, for me, the default is fine, and I'll click next. And then I'm going to click install now. Then here, if you have a key, you're going to enter it here. If you don't have a key, you have 30 days to try it out, but you can either enter your key and click next, or I don't have a key and click right here. Okay, then you're going to select your operating system. When you enter the key, it's going to know what operating system it is, but because we didn't enter a key, we have to manually enter it here. I'm going to click Windows 10 Pro and click next. Make sure to read through all of this information. It's all incredibly important. And when you're done and you agree, you click I accept the license term and click next. I always recommend to click here, custom install Windows only advanced. So click that. Now here we're going to see, depending on how many hard drives or SSDs or different drives you have plugged into your computer, you might see a bunch of these. If you only have that one brand new drive you purchased in your machine, you're going to select drive zero unallocated space. Now, if you have, let's say you wanted to install on another SSD, I always recommend for this particular purpose to unplug, like you see here, unplug your other drives, that way you don't by mistake erase those drives. You can see here drive one, both of these are drive one, different partitions. This is one drive, it's 500 gigs. Then we have drive two, shows a few more partitions. This one is also 500 gigs. when you delete them all individually, they become one drive just like this. We're going to focus on the unallocated space. Unallocated means the drive has never been formatted, it's never been used, it's completely blank. And again, I recommend if you've had this computer for quite some time or just, you know, for a little while and you have other drives, shut down your computer, unplug the drives, restart your computer and start this process over so that the unallocated space drive is the drive you see here, and then click next. What the next did is it automatically partitioned the drive like Windows needs. So then what it's doing right now, it's copying all of the files from that thumb drive or CD onto that SSD. And then it's going to be doing all of the expanding and then getting everything ready. So this entire process takes about 3, 4, 5, 6 minutes. And I'll go ahead and fast forward through all of this. I still want you to see it, but I'll fast forward so that it doesn't take all of that time. Okay, so now that this time we can go ahead and click restart now. Now it's going to restart your computer. Okay, so now when the system reboots, we're going to go ahead and make sure you remove your thumb drive at this point. And now it'll start booting onto your brand new Windows 10 drive and continue on the installation. Okay, so then we can see here, it's getting all your devices and all your drivers, everything ready for your initial boot. And don't worry, it's going to reboot a few times while you're doing this process. Okay, so let's start with region. Is this right? We're going to select whatever region we're from. For me, I'm in the United States, and I'll click yes. And then the keyboard layout again. Because I'm in the United States, I'll leave US as default and click yes. I don't want to add a second keyboard layout, but if you did want to, just click it here. I'll go ahead and skip it for now. So at this point, if you do have an Ethernet cable connected to it and you're on a network, it's doing a few updates to your install. And so you can either set it up for personal use or set up for an organization. I'll click for personal use and click next. Okay, at this point, we're gonna go ahead and sign on with a Microsoft account or create a brand new account. It doesn't have to be a Microsoft account, but I'm gonna go ahead and enter mine in, so 1 second. Okay, and it might start resizing and everything as you're doing the install, as it's auto-detecting your hardware. So at this point, I'm gonna go ahead and enter in the password for my account. Create a PIN. It's always a good idea to create a PIN, just an easier way to get into Windows. So 1 second, then enter it again to confirm and then click OK. Now for that one, it is numeric and you can spread your activity history, maybe on another Windows install you've done before. And for now, I'm just gonna click no, keep it fresh. And I'm gonna go ahead and skip this for now. I'll click do it later. Backup your files with OneDrive. If you have a OneDrive account, this is a great option. Even if you don't, this might be a great option. I don't particularly use it, so I'm gonna go ahead, click only save files to this PC. OneDrive is Microsoft's online backup utility. Achieve more with a free Office 365 home trial. I'll just click no for this. You can click yes or have a product key. It's a great option, but I'll click no. Get help from your digital assistant. Now, if you like to use digital assistants, Microsoft's version is Cortana. I'm gonna go ahead and click decline here. But if you want to use Cortana, you just need to make sure you have a microphone. So I'll click decline. And then these are all the different types of privacy settings. For this install, I'll just click accept. And now it's going through the introduction and just getting everything ready for you. This will take a few more seconds, or depending on how fast your computer is, a few minutes. And I'll fast forward through this. All right, so we're in Windows. We're completely done installing Windows. Now, the other part that might take you a little bit longer. Unfortunately, I can't help you with it because we're all gonna have different hardware, is now you have to install all of your drivers. So you're gonna want to see what kind of video card you have, what kind of sound card, what kind of processor chipset to help you build your install of Windows and complete it. So in this series, I'm gonna show you how to install everything, your video card, your SSD, your processor. So we'll get into all of this very soon. All right, guys, I hope I've helped you out. If you have any questions, please do leave them in the comments below. I would love to help you guys. Yeah, see you guys.